All right, it's Kuya P, Nerds of Color. I am excited and delighted to be joined by Mouse, y'all, from Charm City Kings, Jahi Diallo Winston. Did I get the name right, brother? Did I say it right?
Yes, you did. You said it amazingly, man.
I appreciate it, bro, man. As I was telling you earlier, man, if you don't get some trophies from Charm City Kings, man, they playing, man. You were outstanding. It was a banger. I enjoyed the film thoroughly. All my crew saw it that did the review with me, loved it. Man, you deserve something for this, man.
Thank you, man. I'm going to bring you to when I go to the Academy, all right? I'm going to be like, hey,
stop playing. I'll be there. You know what I'm saying? I haven't gone to the award show yet, but I'm ready to roll.
Yeah, good, man.
So I wanted to know, man, playing Mouse, what did you connect most with the character of Mouse?
I think just his desire and his like, every regular things from him being a teenager. I mean, his desire to get validation from his friends and from the girl he likes, like, all of those things go into him just being a regular kid. And I said earlier, like, I wanted him to be seen as any other white male suburban protagonist in any other coming of age story. He's just been dealt a different set of cards. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I wanted him to, the audience, to be able to connect with who he is as a human being, as opposed to his circumstances or the environment in which he was inevitably born into.
Definitely. We definitely did. I don't think this film would have succeeded if not for you. You were outstanding in the role. What was the most difficult aspect of playing Mouse?
Probably like the roller coaster of emotions was tough. And trying to stay there and stay in the moment as an actor was really difficult for me. I had help, which, thank God, because I couldn't have done that by myself. But just staying in the moment as an actor and being really in touch and in tune with the levity, not the levity, but the intensity of the scene, and the just the overall deep and sort of dark moments was hard. And it was hard for me as Jahi to get to a place where, okay, I can let my emotional guard down to be able to channel this emotion from Mouse. So that was probably the most difficult, and all of like the convenience store stuff, that was hard. So yeah.
Okay. Do you have a favorite moment on set? And how was it working with Meek, man, who's kind of like a non-actor now stepping into this? He was kind of like a Mr. Miyagi to your Danielson.
Yeah. Working with Meek was great. It was great to see him sort of get more comfortable throughout the period of filming and let his guard down a little bit and be in the moment with me. And there was one specific moment towards the end of shooting where I was like, oh, this is great. Like, he's killing it. Like, I almost forgot my line. I'm like, oh, all right. But he's dope. And I think a lot of people are going to be impressed with his performance in this. He does an incredible job. And I had a lot of great moments filming, man. Like, every day was a memorable moment. It was a highlight reel, this film, really.
Amazing. Well, hey, you got thug tears to me, man. Even all my partners, we at the end, you know what I'm saying? We didn't want to give it away in our review, but bruh, we had to have a moment because that it just hit. Just all those moments, the moment with me, all of that. It was fascinating, man. It was amazing. What do you hope people leave with after seeing this film?
I hope people are just able to understand the core message, which is one decision can change your life forever, you know, especially when you are in a disenfranchised community. You know what I'm saying? It affects the trajectory of your life going forward. And so to be able to get people to see the humanity in this environment and this often overly politicized city and vilified city in the media, and just for people to be able to see these people are human beings and they love and they fall in love and they make mistakes and they do all these things too, but they're still people. And we shouldn't see them as these extraterrestrial beings who live on the outskirts of America or the Bible Belt or wherever. And being a part of delivering that message to the mass audience of people was really, really special for me as an artist and as an actor. So I'm really excited for people to see this film, and hopefully it's as well received as you and your homies. You know,
definitely, so, yeah. Well, man, I'm in the D.C. area, and I've shot a lot of projects in B-more, man. I recognize a lot of those locations, man. I can't wait for you to come back through, man. We want to show y'all some more love, man, when this whole COVID stuff is, you know, down and it's safe, you know.
Sure,
but I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Dope.
I keep my heart in the country, I left my soul in the city. Since I first listened to